I'm putting some purple to make kind of like that purple blue skies. So I mixed red and blue to make the purple, but I added some black to make it like a dark purple. And I blended out my sky because I didn't like the way it came out first. So again, just making some purple highlights here and there. I'm gonna make some pinks because I do want some pinkish, maybe pinkish colors. Now I'm adding some white to my blue because I do want to have some light blue parts, but I'm going to have to blend it as you can see. Blend everything if you don't like the strokes. So before we do some landscape, we're going to add some stars, and that's because I don't want to do it at the end. So I have an old toothbrush. I'm just putting it on the water, taking out excessive water. I'm gonna put it in on, on the toothbrush. And then you can test it out with just on the side if you want, that you're gonna be using your fingers and brushing it this way on the canvas. So you're gonna go like this and then wherever you want more, that's what I'm adding. Like it's a ton of stars. Once you know what you want to add, then you can put it away. If you don't have one, an old one, you can use a brush, but it's funner when you have an old toothbrush. Mine's an old one. You don't need to use it anymore, so you just make sure you put it away and make sure you take out old brushes. You can go back to your water and just go over the splash that you made with the stars, because you don't need them as much. Or if you can, you can leave them, up to you. Maybe like a little reflection. So, now that you have your sky and your water, we're going to make our tent over here. And if you need new napkins, you should always get some. Actually, I'm going to go get some. Okay. So I'm making the ground, and I'm going to make a few things here as my, it's still blank, but I'm gonna make a big tree. And I'm gonna also make the background here. I'll be using black for all the shadows or the background. So here I'm going to make a line. Doesn't have to be perfect. It's just my line to know what area I want to be the water and the sky. And I'm going to make some faraway trees. So first of all, I'm going to make a little hill here and there. If you get other colors on your brush, make sure you always wash out that color, and then you can also, of course, make sure you let it dry. And you might want to use a smaller brush for your little trees. So I'm going to use a small brush that I was provided with and do that. That's just tree after tree after tree. And they're all different sizes. They're pine trees, so just draw a pine tree. And it's just a shadow of the pine tree, so it doesn't have to be perfect. You can't see them anyway. They're far away. And whatever you do on the top, the reflection should also show. And reflections don't have to be very defined, they can just be pieces of it since it's in the water. So same on the other side. Make them big, or you want to make them small, up to you. How big you want to make them. And make this side really, really big. Well, not super big, just enough that it's gonna say that there's a big tall tree on that side. Same thing on the reflections. And if you feel you made a mistake, I'm just gonna do it really quick. Just to say like I made a mistake or I didn't like it. You can always go back with, say, your blue, and just go over it. Let it dry, of course. I'm just doing it, well, it's still wet, but you can change it. Or you can blend it, up to you. And add some whites as well, if you like. I'm gonna draw a moon. I think I'm gonna draw a moon right there. So that's up to you how you want your moon. I'm just gonna make maybe half a circle. No, I haven't decided. But you can always turn around your canvas and make the moon. I have to let it dry first because I feel this one's still wet. But if you do make the moon, remember to put some highlights on that side too. Come back. That's my moon. Now I'm going to make a big tree here. Again, using my black, but I'm going to go back to that medium size brush I had because it's a bigger tree, and I'm gonna make one here. I'm gonna make one right. Should make it somewhere here. That's just like the trunk, and I'm gonna make one right here. That's like right behind, somewhere in the back or something. Again, you're gonna have to make sure you let your side that's wet dry. So I'm gonna let it dry on that side while I do the one here. And again, pine tree. There is never a perfect pine tree, so I'm just adding that section. Again, my ground is somewhere there. That's my tree. And fill it in a bit. This side, if it is dry. If it is not dry, again, let it dry for the purposes of this tutorial. I am trying to you should outline your tent. I'm actually gonna make this dark in here because I feel maybe we should make it dark. I'm adding brown because the light is in there inside. Sorry if you can't see it, but that's what I did, build it in. Go back with your black on your tent and maybe make those wires. Oops. Again, you don't want to like it. It can always water down. And just start over again. You might have to make your, maybe you can use a ruler, permanent marker, so you can make a straight line. I think I'm gonna have to do it this way. Again, just using my thinnest brush that I have. And then I'm gonna add some green to my trees a bit so that they know, I mean, if we know that, we know that they're green, some green leaves. So you could do that with yellow and blue if you don't have green. And just dab a few. I'm using my small brush, but I should be using my big brush, especially because I want to make sure that you know that the light is coming from these, from our tent, so green and some green there. I'm going back to my medium size. Oops. Never leave these in there. You can use that one, or you can use your big one again, since you do want them to be the green color to show. Have to be a lot, just a little. You can always add additionally some fire. So I'm just gonna make a quick one. If you don't wanna add it, you don't have to. I'm just using brown. If you don't have brown, again, it would be red, orange, and blue to make a brown. But I'm just gonna make some quick logs here. And then my orange. My yellow. Little bit of white. And if you want to do some little fumes, you can. You might want to use your smaller brush, but I'm just making it quickly here. And that's it. You can add other stuff as well. You can add comments, you can add more stars, up to you. So there is your art piece.